So, we've totally omitted so far is the channel. So this bit between the transmitter and the receiver. So if we have here the transmitter, then this has an aerial here, and then on the other side we have got the receiver. So the receiver is here, and this also has an aerial, and then in between here, in this transmission here, there we've got here the channel. The problem with the channel is that obviously very often we don't know much about this, about its characteristics, but we could describe the channel that we say, okay, so that's our channel C. So that's C, and it has a frequency response which we can divide up into an amplitude response depending on the frequency, and in a phase response. Yeah, so we can define an angle theta here, so that's the amplitude response. And this is here the frequency, the angle response, so the angular distortion of this. And obviously, depending on our modulation scheme, if we're thinking of QAM, or if we are, so then obviously both aspects are pretty important here. So imagine we have a transmission like this QAM constellation here, like real and imaginary. So let's say this is here QAM, and then because of the channel transmission on the receiving side, so imagine this the whole thing might be so the angle response rotated, and because of the amplitude response also just turned into different levels. So imagine our pattern, our constellation looks like that. This obviously makes it virtually impossible to decode this properly if this is rotated and the amplitude information is suddenly also changed. So if we have something like that, and so therefore this obviously causes problems. So ideally what we need to do is we need to take care of these two distortions here, and ideally correct them so that the receiver gets exactly the same signal what is transmitted.